Hi, welcome to a different kind of video. This is gonna be kind of like a hybrid, sort of. We are going to do a proof, and we're gonna accompany it with an example. Mostly because the proof is really short, but this is the proof for this example. Again, it's gonna be talking about diagonalization, and this is gonna be looking at the unique properties or the unique things that you can do with the diagonal matrix. So this example is, or I guess not example, this proof is giving us a matrix A that's n by n, and we know that it's diagonalizable. We're also given a matrix P that it is invertible, so such that B is equal to the inverse of, that was supposed to be, I just realized this S, or this P was supposed to be an S. S is invertible such that matrix B is equal to the inverse of S times A times S. We can substitute B for being D, where D is just diagonalizable. So now we have to prove that B raised to some power of K is equal to the inverse of S times the matrix A raised to some power of K times S, where K is a positive integer. So this is, we're raising it to a full power. So what we're going to do here is, I guess, like a direct proof. But first we're just going to do a bit of observation. So B to the K is pretty much going to be equal to S to the inverse of S times S times K, or all raised to the K. So if we do B squared, we are going to get S to the negative 1 AS times S to the negative 1 A S. And if you can see here, we can group these S's because that will give us an identity matrix, which is the equivalent of just being 1. So this will reduce down to S to the negative 1 times A times A times S, or S to the negative 1 times A squared times S. So that's interesting. So what if we raise it to the third power? Again, we have negative 1 AS times negative 1 AS times our third SAS. And again, it shows up. We can group these S's, which will give us the identity matrix. And this will just be S to negative 1 A times A times A times S, or S to negative 1 times A cube S. So we're starting to see a pattern here. So how are we going to prove this? So now that we solve like specific problems, let's try doing this more generally. So B to the K is going to be equal to S inverse times A times S, multiplied by S inverse AS, multiplied by S inverse AS, dot dot dot, multiplied by S inverse AS. We're doing this K times. And then now what we can do here is we can start grouping the S and the S inverse, because those will just give us the identity matrix. And this will just, they will all give us the identity matrix. So this will be S1 is multiplied by A times A, all the way to A times S. And we can simplify this to S inverse times A to the K times S. And that is our proof of the problem. So now let's do a couple of examples. So now using what we proved, so pretty much B of K is equal to S of inverse A of K times S, we can now find powers of A. And so we are going to do part A. We might do part B in a separate video, but let's do part A. And so how are we going to do this? Well, we can just substitute B with D, that is a diagonal matrix, And so all we really have to do is we rewrite this. B of k is equal to s inverse a of k times s. And then we can rewrite this in terms of a of k, so a raised to the k, is going to be equal to s times d of k times s inverse. And so, like usual, we have to find our diagonal matrix. And what that usually means is find our eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So our characteristic equation will simply be this, what I have written down here. And we know this is going to be equal to 10 minus lambda times negative 11 minus lambda minus plus, we have the negative 6. So it'll be 6 times 18. It'll be 108. Yep, I think. And so now we can distribute this a little bit further. So we have negative 110 plus 108 plus lambda squared plus lambda. And that will be equal to lambda squared plus, is it plus lambda? Negative, positive, yeah. Plus lambda minus 2, which will give us lambda plus 2, lambda minus 1. And we're going to see that our eigenvalues is going to be equal to negative 2 and 1. And to find our eigenvector, when we let lambda equal to negative 2, we will see that we will get 12, negative 6, 18, negative 9. And so our vector is going to be, 18. Okay, 18. So we can do, this is equal to negative 3, and this would be 2, right? Yeah. 2, because it would be 18 minus 2, and then it would be the same thing. Negative 36 minus, no, negative 36 plus 30. Okay, yeah. So now when lambda is equal to 1, we get the matrix 9, negative 6, 18, negative 10. No, negative 12, I think. And so our vector will be 2, negative 1. And so our s will simply be negative 3, 2, 2, negative 1. Our inverse, it is 1 over 3 minus 4 times negative 1, negative 2, negative 2. Negative 3. And so our d, we already know what our d is because it's just the eigenvalues, but it has to correspond with the eigenvectors. And so because the first column will be negative 3, 2, which is negative, the eigenvector negative 2, so it'll be negative 2 and then 1. And so now we're looking for a to the 6. So what we have to do is raise this to the 6th power, and we get that this would be 32001. And now we have to multiply this by the s and the s inverse. And so we will get negative 322, negative 1 times 32010. And so this will just be all positives. 1, 2, 2, 3. And I realized that this is supposed to be a 64 because that's to the 5th. 64. And so now, as usual, we leave the first part alone, multiply the last two. So we'll have 64 times 1 is 64. And then 0, second one will be 64 times 2 equals 128 times 0, so 128. And then the other one would be 0, 1, and this would be 2. This would be 0, this would be 3. And so now we multiply the other matrix corresponds to it, and we will get that this will be negative 192 plus 4, and then 120 times 3 is equal to negative 3625. No, 6784 plus 6, and then we'll have 64, so this would be 128 minus 2, and then 256 minus 3. And I realized we kind of carried over part B, so this would give us negative 188, 126, negative 378, and 253. And that is our answer to A to the 6. So I am pass over the 10-minute mark and kind of don't want to do part B in this video, so I'm gonna stop here. I'm gonna do part B in a separate video, and we're gonna see it's pretty much the same thing. Again, it's just we're gonna get 3x3 matrix, so it's gonna be a little longer example. So till then, I will see you guys in the next video.